Chapter 1, Lesson 4. File and Folder Management. In this lesson, we will cover how to rename a file, renaming multiple files at once, overview of folders and subfolders, how to create a folder and subfolder, and how to move files inside the folders. Welcome again to our Windows 7 Basic to Advanced Video Learning Series. Before we go further, as you can see, I have collected some more files in Documents folder. This is because, today, we are going to run several commands, which will be applied on multiple files. It is necessary for you to have some more files in your Documents folder, so you may understand the commands more accurately. You can also save as the file, which we had created in our previous exercise, using the Save As command in Notepad. To do this, double-click on the file, click File menu, click Save As and type a new name. Repeat this for 10 to 12 times, so you may have sufficient files to practice our current exercise. It is very much important that you must type appropriate file names to your documents so it may be easier for you to identify the files through their names. As you can see in the list of my files, there are a lot of files that do not have any meaningful names. So first, I am going to rename all of my files as per their contents. You can also rename a file by selecting the file and pressing F2 from the keyboard. You can also rename a file by first selecting the file and then again clicking on file name once more. Do not be too fast, otherwise it will be like double-clicking the file and the file will get open instead of renaming. In Windows 7, you can also rename multiple files at once. This is a very useful feature if you want to rename multiple files with similar names but with just a number in the end of the file name. Here, I give you an example. As you can see, I have another subcontainer, we call them subfolders, under Documents menu, Name, Sounds. If I double-click this folder, then you can see that the subfolder contains 8 files with numbered name. I want to rename them all as Chapter 1 Lesson 4 Sound 1, 2, 3, and so on. To do this, I will select all the files at once. To select all files, I can use two popular methods. First one is selecting the first file by clicking on it and then hold Sound Shift key from your keyboard and click on the last file name. The second method is to make rectangle from outside to inside by holding down the left mouse click. Now, all the files get selected, press F2 key to rename, or you can also choose right-click, rename command, to rename the first file. After typing the name, press Enter key, and Windows will automatically rename all other files with the same name but having a number in the end. As I had said in my previous video, that I will explain you how to create folders and subfolders. So, let's take a look how to create a folder and subfolders to manage our files. Before we begin creating new folders, let's first have an overview that why we actually need folders and subfolders. As you are looking into this folder, there are total 57 files exist in this folder. If you are working on a computer and regularly create new files, download pictures and videos from internet and saving all of your data into a single folder, then imagine how many files will be there in that particular folder after a month. And what about after a year? This is totally a disorganized folder, consisting of mixed data, like documents, pictures, and videos. Computers are made for long-term use. If you are working on personal computer from last many months or years, then visualize what will happen if you do not organize your files properly. It will be hard for you to find a single document inside from 1,000 files if they are not properly named and organized in folders. So, to manage our files properly, we need folders and subfolders so we can separate our data according to their importance, and it will make ease for us to find data when needed. So, how we can create a folder? This is a very simple task to do. As you can see, there is a button in the top bar called New Folder. If you click this button once, a new folder will instantly be created with a temporary name called New Folder. As you see, your cursor is inside the box, asking you to type a new name. Once again, I am reminding you that it is important to give meaningful names to the folders as well. The file and folder names should be something like that. They will be telling us what inside them. I type a name for my new folder and press Enter key to finalize. However, you can rename your folders as well, as I had described previously in renaming your files. You can also create a new folder by right-clicking on an empty area, pointing on New, and then click on New Folder. Type a name for your new folder and hit Enter key. So, we have created new folder. Now, what next? As I said earlier, folders are used to store and separate our files. Our next step is to move our files inside our folders. The easiest method to move a file inside a folder is to select the file and hold down the left click, Now Move Your File, toward the folder, and release the button. Your file will get cut and paste automatically. You can also call it Smart Cut and Paste. To check it, double-click on the folder, and you will see that the file you had moved is there. To go back to the previous location, you can click on the back button from the top bar. To give you a more clear idea of organizing files, I am going to create some more folders and will move my files inside them. You can also create subfolders inside your folders, as required. For instance, I am going to create subfolders inside the Other Documents folder. So you may now have some idea of creating folders and subfolders, what is the benefit or creating them. We will talk more about folders in our future videos. My name is Rajiv Kohli and do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorials.